Good morning, Mr. McClain. Welcome into the Blitz. How you doing, sir?
Man, I'm good. How you doing, man? Good morning. Good morning.
Doing good. Doing good. See, LeRon, I wonder if you're like me. At least after I left, I got to enjoy you and McClintock and a couple other guys.
Yes, sir.
Man, do you watch football and go where the real men at in the backfield?
Man, always, always. I was talking to a guy the other day, man. I was like, man, I think I was the last of the dying breed to come through there, man. And I was wondering in the draft, like who got picked? But they said the fullback from Auburn got picked up late round. So
yeah, he was the only one, only fullback taken.
Look at that. That's bad. He pretty good. Like, and yes. I know he gonna do pretty good in the league too. So.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to seeing him.
Yeah, yeah. But LeRon, I mean, we'll talk a little bit about your career here at Alabama and how the that Pro Bowl season came about in NFL. But I want to make sure that people know that you've been on the day is about the weekend you have coming up at the end of this month. That's what we want to talk about, and then we'll get back to the football. But tell us a little bit about what LeRon McClain is doing and specifically about that weekend. I've given a little shout out, but I want to make sure we dig into that before we get into the football stuff.
Oh, yes, sir, man. It's just, man, God wins. I said, God is amazing in my life right now, man. So I just want to give, you know what I'm saying, the first, just due to God, man, just being in this position, a blessing to be a blessing. Back down here in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, man, Noah Port, where I started at, God done pushed me back down here, man. But at the end of the month, May 30th through June 1st, I'm having a charity weekend, man, raising money for the Benjamin Barnes YMCA on the west side of Tuscaloosa and also for my foundation. And also just putting on a few events for the city, man, just giving back and everything. May 31st, I booked Tuscaloosa River Market. I'm having an alpha male, like, fashion show, you know what I'm saying, showcasing my clothing line, and also teamed up with Rodney High with his clothing line and everything. So we're gonna put on a nice show. Then that night we having the summer social for the city. Invited everybody out. I invited the mayor out, both mayors of Tuscaloosa and Northport, all the city councilmen, the chamber in Tuscaloosa, everybody. you invited everybody over there at the station. Invited, you know. So and then, you know, I'm ended it with the thing that I started when I was younger, man. Just being a young guy from Fort Wayne, Indiana, getting to go to Rod Woodson, you know what I'm saying, a guy from Fort Wayne, went to Snyder High School in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Be able to go to a free camp when I was a kid, probably the only camp I could go to as a kid. When I left that field that day as a kid, I said, man, if I ever get the opportunity, because I always said I was going to the NFL. I think as soon as I jumped up out of the hospital, out the hospital bed. But I said, any chance I get to get in the NFL, I always want to come back and do a free camp for the kids. So it's time. I'm back at it this year. June 1st, we're going to be at ACA, American Christian Academy, you know, for my football and cheer camp, you know. And then honoring my late friend, Brandon Washington, who passed away recently, man. Due to him, just shout out to him, rest in power. So I just wanted to change my camp name, honor him. He always say life is 10% what happened to you, 90% how you react to it. So we just changed it to the 1090 Brandon Washington Football and Cheer Camp, Saturday, June 1st, man, at ACA. Sign them kids up.
All right. Hey, and guys, if y'all want to find out a little bit more about the camp, we're going to talk about it a little bit more, but follow at LeRon underscore McClain 33. That's at LeRon underscore McClain with two C's, number 33. Follow that. And James, if we could tweet that out from our Tide account, he has the flyer for the alpha male night, the clothing line, doing a little philanthropy and fundraising. Oh, yeah. and all of that, man. So definitely want to make sure that we do that. And I told LeRon we would have him on a couple times before that.
I appreciate it too.
Oh, no doubt. You know, some things are meant to be, and LeRon and I were both out late last night trying to find a restaurant that was open to get a bite to eat. And you just never, you know, the power. You talk about 10% what happens, 90% how you respond. And I've heard you over the years talk and talk about giving back to the community. And the only reason I knew who he was I recognized his voice from having heard him. I'm like, hold on, who is that? And so, but man, I awesome on the football cheer camp. We'll talk more about that. But let's talk a little football, and then we'll get back to Brandon because I want people to learn a little bit more about Brandon because we both have a personal tie to Brandon. So you're going to be with us for this segment and the second quarter and the third quarter. So we'll make sure we wrap up things talking about that free camp.
Yes, sir.
Well, LeRon, man, local kid coming from County High. A lot of guys went off during that era when you came to Alabama. A lot of guys that were D1 talent for Tuscaloosa were leaving and going, and Brandon was one of those guys that went down to LSU and played for Nick Saban along with Bishop. But what made you decide to stick with the Tide and as LeBron has made famous, bring your talent to Tuscaloosa?
Oh man, it was a lot. I feel like if people understood like how that process was, because like I committed under Mike Price, and you know the stuff happened with Mike Price, and then I decommitted, you know. But it was a true blessing to have Mike Shula. You know, people don't understand like that. People probably don't want to remember the Shula years, but him coming in, man, saved me. You know, so I think him saved me with that pro style offense. And it was perfect. It was perfect. It was just like perfect, man. Everything when I chose Alabama, you know, between Alabama and Mississippi State, the ending, and you know, I chose Alabama, man, probably the best decision I made, man. And you know, 4 years later, you know, it speaks for itself, man. I do not regret any of those 4 years at Alabama, man. I love that school.
That's awesome. Hey, you know, it's kind of funny when you talk about getting the right fit, but then people not necessarily liking the coach. I was kind of the same way as you were. Perkins didn't recruit me, wasn't recruiting me. And I'm going into my, senior year, LeRon, and they're talking about hiring Bobby Bowden. And I'm like, man, I'm not going to fit there. So Alabama was about to be marked off my list and they hired Bill Curry. And the guy that they hired, the recruiting guy, for my area, had recruited my high school in the late 70s and had signed two guys from my high school and said, I wonder if they have any talent at that school now. And 10 years later. So it's kind of crazy but then you get here and of course you fall in love with that crimson jersey and all that it stands for. Now, seeing if it's the same. You played fullback, but were a tailback at heart. Would I be correct in that?
Oh, it's got to be that, man. Just going to kind of high, going. I was telling the kid at the barbershop the other night, man. I said it's just crazy, just being that kind of high, man, getting the ball like 30 times a game, and then going into that first meet in Alabama, and a coach telling you, "Hey, you're not carrying the ball. You're going to be straight blocking." And I'm like, oh man, for real? Like, I'm like, man, I was almost the top running back in the state coming out, you know. So, but I showed value, man. I showed value in 2008, man. Cam Cameron gave me my shot in the league, and I took off.
Yeah, and I'm going to get to that because that is so true. But LeRon, I hated blocking with a passion. But that was the only way I was going to get on the field, having been a tailback in high school as well. What was it about your game that probably was the hardest part of what you did, but you really worked really hard at it? Was it receiving, blocking? I know the running part came easy, but what about that other aspect of the game?
I think it was just transitioning to a blocker because I hardly did it in high school. You know, I did it a little bit, you know what I'm saying, blocking for, you know, Titus Ryan and David McCants a few times, you know, but I just took pride in it. I just said, man, if I'm going to do anything, I remember Sparky Woods told me, he said, if you want to be professional, man, you're going to have to block, you know, so I just took pride in it. I just said, man, whoever in front of me, man, they're in trouble. you can tell by the way that I played the game, you know, physical, you know, I'm going to set the tone. I love when we was playing the middle linebacker or something like this. This was in the NFL or college. I was like, coach, start to play. All right, 20 ISO. I need to set the tone. That's right. I'm going right at him. So man, I just took pride, and I took pride in just being that guy, being that thumper, you know. But I'm paying for it a little bit right now when I get up in the morning. Hey.
Well, 49 is coming. Yeah, because that was my philosophy. My philosophy was pretty similar to yours, man. It's like, I'm gonna hit that man in the mouth. I'm gonna try to knock his teeth out. If he goes left, I'm gonna drive him left. He goes right, I'm gonna take him right. And you better make the right move off of it. So we both kind of played it the same way, very, very intense. And like I said, man, I really, really enjoyed watching you play the game, because we don't get to see that. And as you watch football now, and you watch Alabama now, and you see all these third and ones and goal lines, and you see them come out in a
spread
or the quarterback 6 yards back and on the snap the running back's waiting on it. If it drives you crazy like it does me, it's just frustrating to watch sometimes. And people say we're old school, but I'm like, LeRon McClain was not a non-athlete that could block. LeRon McClain was a running back that could block.
You like the fifth person that said that.
Yeah. Well, LeRon, I mean, when you look at it, let me tell you what one of my most frustrating parts is. When people say, well, they use the fullback and they run in like DeRon Payne or Mount Cody. I tell people all the time, the most insulting part of watching football now is when they run those guys in.
Man, so I remember one game. I go back to one game right now. We played the Washington Redskins one Sunday, and you know, we driving the ball. It's like the end of the fourth quarter, and we about to score. We get down to the goal line. When I tell you on Thursdays, I know me personally. I had to play. I had to stay in 12 straight plays because we're going over goal line. Mm-hmm. So we get down to the 1 yard line, and we go spread. then look, second down, we go to goal line. But we pass the ball, we throw the fade. Then we go right back to spread. Man, when I tell you, when I got on the bus that night, because we lost the game, like we had to go to overtime. Mm-hmm. And then RG3 and them throw the ball all the way down. They scored. You know, we didn't get a chance, and they did it. But that day was like, why do we go over goal line in practice, and we get in the game, and you go spread? Like he apologized like that Wednesday. I said, it's too late now.
We're speaking with LeRon McClain, former Alabama great, NFL two-time All-Pro. We're going to flip the script a little bit. Talk a little bit about that pro career, and then we're also going to let you know what he has coming up at the end of the month. And LeRon, I want to get a little bit of thoughts on what you see with Alabama now, and what Nick Saban is doing and how impressive that is as well. You listen to the Blitz on Tide 102.9 and 100.9. We're back in with LeRon McClain and the 1090 Brandon Washington Football and Cheer Camp coming up Saturday, June 1st. It's a free camp for the youth, 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. at American Christian Academy. Parents, you're going to be able to purchase credentials to be down on the field. There's early registration via email at McClainAllStarGame33@gmail.com. You want to find out more information about this, give a follow to LeRon_McClain33. That's LeRon underscore McClain with two C's, the number 33, representing the Alabama Crimson Tide and at Baltimore Raven career, as well as a stint with the Chiefs and the Chargers. Ask Mr. LeRon McClain. You can call the Taco Casa hotline if you got a question for LeRon, 205-342-9904. LeRon, you know, it's kind of funny. It's three guys that all remind me of each other. And this is not trying to be ugly, but here's the thing. I am convinced that fullbacks may not have as many long runs, but the athletic fullbacks, and it's three of you guys that I kind of put in the same category in the NFL, that when was given opportunity, did exactly or more than what the running backs on the teams were doing at that time.
Oh, and
that's Mike Allstott. I put you in that. Yep. Mike Allstott, when he got his chance to have 200 plus carries, he got over 900 yards rushing. Peyton Hillis, when he got his 200 plus carries, got over 1,000 yards rushing. And then, of course, your career where you had the 200 plus carries, and you, I think you had the fewest total of those guys, and you had over 900 yards. And so what led to them finally giving you that opportunity? Because it was never about whether you had the talent to do it. And of course, LeRon, I have to say, you had a little more juice in the tank than I did. I wasn't going 82 yards. I remember your 82 yard run. That wasn't going to happen. So, but what led to that opportunity, as far as, your second year in the league and then getting that chance to just, show what you had? And it'd been a while for you. It'd been what, 5 years and some change before you got that opportunity to be that ball carrier.
Yeah, it was just such a blessing, man, getting Cam Cameron. I remember Cam Cameron, the first NFL meme that I had leaving Alabama at the combine in Indianapolis. He was with the Miami Dolphins. He brought me in the room, and like they were so fascinated that I knew the offense. Like, I was ringing, like, when I left that meeting, I was ringing around like the NFL, like, man, this guy knows a lot. But when he got to the Ravens, his first day there, he told me, he said, man, you know you're going to carry the ball, right? I was like, that's my opportunity. I can do that. But going to training camp that year, I remember Ray Lewis telling me that because people don't even know, man, I failed the conditioning test that year going into 08. And I remember Ray Lewis sent me down, man. He said, man, if you want to be a professional in this league, you want to be great in this league, you got to take advantage of your opportunity. And that always stuck to me. So, you know, when Cam Cameron said I'm going to have a chance to run the ball, it was crazy. Everybody started getting hurt in training camp. It was just me and Ray Rice in training camp. And I just took off. I started doing like a lot of one back stuff, and it was like, whoa, like they start seeing it. And, you know, I just got in the mix, man. And during the season, it's like everything just conformed to me. And then we bung in Lorenzo Neal. My guy that I looked up to blocking.
Yeah.
In college, I studied him in college blocking, so he got to come in 2008 and block for me. So that took my whole game to another level. Like, we was getting up, I was meeting him at the facility. You know, I'm like a young kid. I'm like a fan. Like, when he came in, this is my second year in the league. So he say be there at 5:30. I'm there at 4:45 waiting on him. Waiting on him in the weight room. Say, I'm already in here. I already got like 15 minutes in. Really, just trying to tell him, like, man, I just want to be the best. And, like, man, I'm talking about, I listened to everything that he told me that year, man. And everything happened. Everything he said, man. He said he's going to be all pro, first team, pro bowler, man, everything. And it happened. You know, I closed down Dallas Cowboys Stadium that year.
Yeah, man, it was a great season to watch. Tell us a little bit, LeRon, what it was like going against a Ray Lewis and in the type of influence that he had, and probably not just on the field, but even in the intensity of how you approach life.
Yeah, it's so crazy. Like, there's a weekend that's coming up, this charity weekend, McClain Summer Days. I got that name from Ray Lewis coming up there in 07, man. The first event that I attended was his charity weekend. It was Ray, he called it Ray Summer Days. He would raise the money, you know what I'm saying, for a center down in Baltimore. But just, it's so crazy. The first day I'm walking in the locker room and I see Ray Lewis, I walk back out. I had to get myself together. I walk back out, get myself together. I walk in just because I'm always trying to be the first in the building, man. But he was the first in the building, so you already know what type of guy he was. So when I walked in there, man, I just said, man, Mr. Ray Lewis, how you doing? He said, man, I know who you are, LeRon. that took it off then. And then people don't know, man, our first day in pads, me and him, they put me up there. LeRon, all right, you up against Ray. Pass pro drill.
Wow.
I wasn't scared at all. Went up there, stuck Ray, stopped him in his, he could tell you this right now, stopped him in his track. He couldn't go nowhere, blocked him. But I promise you, after that practice, he took me to the side and said, man, I respect you. You're going to be a great player in this league, man. Just stay to it. You know what I'm saying? Stick to it. So just having a guy, playing with a guy like Ray Lewis, Ed Reed, Derek Mason, Chris McAllister, man, Samari Rowe, Jonathan Ogden, and then, man, Steve McNair. People don't even know, man, Steve McNair was my rookie quarterback, you know, mm-hmm. our rest in power. to see me there, man. But I said I was blessed, man, just to, my football career, man, going into a locker room like that as a rookie, you know, playing with, being blocking for Willis McGahee, you know what I'm saying? He came in my rookie year, man. You know,
wow.
Yeah, man. So it was just like, I try to tell people, I won't regret anything. It was amazing. I wish I would have just stayed at the Ravens my whole career, but you know how that go.
Yeah, you know, we have choices and decisions, and some work out, but we can learn from all of them. And as you say on Twitter, man, things are on the uptick and heading in the right direction, and you're giving a little bit back because of that, and that's what we appreciate, and that's what I wanted to highlight. Let me ask you a couple questions about the current Alabama Crimson Tide. When you look at what Nick Saban is doing and what he's done in terms of keeping all of this talent happy. How impressive is what Nick Saban has been able to do in terms of getting these guys, keeping these guys, and then having the results on the field?
Oh, it's just amazing. Guys, you know, guys buy in from day one. Buying from day one to his philosophy, man, because, I mean, if you come in and ready to compete and want to win, you know, that's a school for you, you know. But you're going to have to, you know, rent is due every day at Alabama. You know, you're going to have to put in some work every day at Alabama. So that's why I respect every guy that goes to Alabama, because that's a different kind of animal to go over there and do the work that they do. That's why we always at the top at the end of the year. But, man, just what Saban has done since he came in, I remember – down in Florida training for the league, and you know, they told me Saban getting hired at Alabama. I said, perfect, you know, so that, and he turned his whole program around, turned this whole city around, you know, him and his wife, man. I just appreciate it. I love it. I love talking mess. Like, I got up this morning and like at 4 o'clock and put a message on the Alabama, on the little college group talking about Alabama. I said, man, I know our team gonna make it to the playoffs. I hope your team do.
Yeah. Former Alabama guy trying to make a claim for being the best, where you come down on this Dabo Sweeney, Nick Saban, Clemson, Alabama conversation?
That's all I say. I was talking about that this morning. I said, okay, Clemson, yeah, they got us one game. If that could have been any other night, Clemson would have beat anybody that night. And that's how I feel. Clemson looked like they was on all cylinders. Yeah, and they caught us one night. That's cool, you know. So everybody want to talk about the Dabo Saban thing. I mean, we'll see. We'll see. That's why I said we'll see. I said we'll see next year if they make it, because I know we are. That's why I said they got to keep we consistent. That's why I said they can have that. We consistent. Like what we 2-2 now in the title game against Clemson.
Yes.
Yeah, so, you know, I mean, we'll see. We just got to see. So I said, it ain't going to be like last year, I tell you that. Saban ain't about to, he ain't about to get them like that. He ain't going to get them like that no more.
Right,
I can't see that. I can't see us losing like that again to a team, you know what I'm saying, like that.
Yeah. Speaking with LeRon McClain, former Alabama great, NFL 2-time All-Pro, has a great weekend coming up. We're going to get to in just a second. Got a couple rapid-fire questions for you. What's your thoughts on the way the game has changed in terms of the physicality and the rule changes?
It's soft. I could imagine how many penalties would have got thrown on me for like going in and blocking somebody, because I used to try to go in there and like really hurt a guy, then get up and say, hey, boss, if by fourth quarter you're gonna be wanting to quit. I know it. So I can imagine like they're just making it so soft. It's gonna be two-hand touching. It's gonna be two-hand touching a little bit, man. It's gonna be two-hand touch. Like, it's just crazy how the league and got, and how the NFL, is.
It's so soft, man. You and I, we think so much alike, and like I said, we played the game a lot alike, I think, in a lot of ways, for different reasons. But we had the same heart. I think you had a little more talent. Especially on the top end.
I was all right, man.
But, hey, LeRon, when you look at they're talking about possibly finally paying these players and letting them take advantage of their name, image, and their likeness, what are your thoughts in terms of just doing something to kind of help these players out?
They got to do something, sir. They got to do something, a stipend or something to get these kids, because they making so much money. just off these kids. I can see how much money the NCAA made off Tyrone Proto's catch.
Yeah,
that he made. You know what I'm saying? Like how they just use his likeness for that catch. You know what I'm saying? But a kid like these big time kids that's coming out of college, they get nothing. Like they were saying, they gonna put that spy cam on Zion coming out. Like he don't get no. Y'all for the had his man on the camera and everything while he in school. It's crazy. I think the NCAA. The NCAA and the NFL are some of the biggest scammers ever. they get most of the money, they get most of everything, and don't have to pay their employees nothing.
Right. It is definitely. I tell people it's not slavery because what our ancestors went through in terms of that. We're playing a game and have a lot of freedoms and can derive some benefits from it, but it's close to indentured servitude or potentially some sharecropping. But it's definitely a huge imbalance in terms of who does work and who rewards from it. LeRon, hey, let's go on some more. I want to make sure I spend the rest of this time. We'll talk a little football the next time. But I got to ask you a question about the running backs. Have you watched the Najee Harris, Brian Robinson debate? What's your thoughts on those two guys? Both big-time backs, but what's your thoughts on those two players?
Man, quick story about Brian Robinson. My first camp that I had at County High, my first ever camp back in 2000, it was right when I got drafted back in 2007, the first camp, a kid come up to me. He's like, Ron, what's going on? My barber brother. He's like, I need your cleats after the camp. And man, guess who? It was Brian Robinson, the kid. He was in the eighth grade then. He was
Wow.
Yes, he was in the eighth grade then, and I gave him my cleats. True story. But I swear, years later, I'm down here looking at high school football, and I'm like, man, it's a kid that Hillcrest and ran for 400 yards one game. Like, but my barber said, that's Brian, man. The kid, he was in the eighth grade, took the cleats. I said, no, that's amazing. But just to see him now, I put up a post, man. He about to have his opportunity now. The man, he just showed value since he's been at the Alabama. Now him and Najee about to have their chance to do their thing. You know, you already know Bama going to have a 1-2 punch.
Yeah.
I say this is going to be some of the most exciting running game I see from these, because you got two power backs with speed. You know what I'm saying? And so I'm looking forward. We back to it. We back to the big back, Eddie Lacy.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Trent Richardson. Let's get down. 60 power. All right, 60 power. Put the fullback in front of him.
You and I have said the same thing. Well, LeRon, we like I said, we got a big weekend coming up. McClain summer days, right?
Yeah, McClain summer days.
Yes, sir. Yeah, and it's a three days of things. I'm gonna hit the camp, but tell us about what you got going on starting on the 30th and the 31st.
Okay, so the 31st, I know that morning, early that morning, 6 a.m. I'm having a nature walk or river walk. I just want people of the city to get up, come fellowship with me. Come fellowship with me and just on a nature hike. You know, I stay big with my fitness now. I lost a lot of weight, you know, so I'm in the mix with my fitness now. So I'm starting off with that morning walk. Then May 31st on Friday, that night at Tuscaloosa River Market, we have a McClain Summer Days and Alpha Male Night, a night of philanthropy and celebration of life in the honor of my great friend, Brandon Washington. You know, then raising funds for the Benjamin Barnes YMCA over here on the west side of Tuscaloosa, man, where my granddaddy was a member at, where I used to go at as a kid, and really just trying to, you know, give back, do anything I can. So it's going to be a night of, you know, have a fashion show with my clothing line, and then I'm going to end it with a summer social for the city, just coming out, fellowship, and having a nice time. And then we coming into that Saturday morning, man. That's what I'm waiting for, you know, the camp, the 1090 Brandon Washington Football and Cheer Camp. You know, honor my friend, because that he was the first guy I was going to ask to come out there and help me coach, man. Didn't even give a chance to get around to him. So I'm going to represent him to the fullest, you know what I'm saying? And just giving back to these kids, man. I can't wait to just see the kids' faces. I'm going to put up a few videos from old camps and everything today, man. So I just can't wait. These parents been blowing my phone. Oh, we need this. I said, I don't care. I hope we have a lot of kids And I said, I hope I run out of shirt. You know, that's like right. 1 year.
That's awesome.
So I'm looking forward to it, man. Just to see these kids' faces, doing anything I can to give back. I was one of these kids, man, and Rod Woodson gave me the opportunity as a kid to come to a free camp. So I said, anytime I can, and this is free. I never charge these kids for a kids game.
Yeah, that's awesome. And I actually was with Rod Woodson up at the Steelers, so that's pretty awesome. And Brandon Washington, for those who don't know, Brandon Washington, Central High athlete, went down and played for the LSU Tigers with Nick Saban, and was in the college coaching game on the weight training side of things, and of course had some medical issues that ended up costing his life. So that's awesome that you're honoring him. We're going to talk about this in between, but we'll also get you back on here to talk more about it. And that's LeRon McClain, like I said, a weapon that was underutilized at Alabama, but got that opportunity to show his skill set, and now doing great things. And I think that's why I didn't recognize you, LeRon. I mean, LeRon, y'all, if y'all run into LeRon McClain walking around here looking like a wide receiver. but keep it up, man. Keep representing. Keep giving back. And like I said, we'll keep giving you shout outs here. We'll tweet it out as well. And we'll get you back on at least once before the camp, maybe once next week, and then one the week of. Man, to talk about what you're doing.
I appreciate y'all, man. It was so. I thank God I ran into you. Like, that was crazy how we ran into each other last night. Just get some food, man. I'll try to get some food.
And at least we were both eating at a healthy place. It was McAllister. We were.
Thank you. Put that out there too. We'll get salad.
That's right. All right, LeRon McClain. Well.